trying to think of something that people can relate to, you know, a mall or a commercial building or something where you can think you can remember having worked on and yep. What you've done to it, just to give a sense of the kind of things that you've done, whether it's improved the building or got rid of tenants or sure. attracted tenants or upgraded. Sure.
So I can tell you about the development site here in Nicosia. So what we had was smack down in the center of the city. We had a beautiful site on which it was an old branch, a bank branch that was sitting there for a number of years. The bank had it at its books at the site value at 10 million, which at the time was significantly overvalued. Because how what was happening in the local economy. We got approached by a developer who offered us 6 million. The bank couldn't take the hit. I mean, they didn't have the 4 million to lose. It was impossible. So what we did there was we agreed with the developer what the gross development value of the project he was planning to do would be. And then we turned around and said, okay, we think our side, being the bank side, we think that you're being too pessimistic. So what we're going to do, we're going to do three things. Number one, what we're going to do, we're going to sign the agreement to sell you the land at 6 million, plus a ratcheting, a profit sharing, or in this case, a revenue sharing mechanism above the gross development value, which he had no reason to object, because if he thought he was going to make, at the time, he was something like 30 million gross development value, anything above that, basically we started getting a cut. The second thing we did was we had
to pay... We would call that overage here. We call that an overage agreement.
Overage agreement, okay. The second thing we did was, instead of him paying us the full amount up front, they paid a million. And then the rest of the money was paid once the building permit was issued. So that obviously saved him money in terms of interest and all these things. And then the third thing that we did was the bank financed, they financed the development. So if you think about it in the bank context, they were giving good loans out. So when you have the ratio of how many non-performing loans do you have? You take the number of non-performing loans and you divide it by the number of performing plus non-performing. So in that constant context, we help the bank as a real estate team to give out that loan.
So it sounds like there's a lot more creativity and entrepreneurialism required in these kind of situations.
Well, let me give you a follow-on to actually what happened with this guy. So actually what happened was that he caught the market going up. So about a year and a half down the line, he came back to us and said, look, you guys are making all the profit here. I mean, this thing is far more successful than I thought it would ever be. I want to buy you out. So what we did was, because clearly, and I know this sounds a bit strange, our aim wasn't to get money. Our aim was to sell even more real estate. So what we turned and said, we said, okay, how about we sell you some more land, which you will pick. So he picked a very nice, a very nice commercial land site, which we sold to him. And then we said, okay, we'll sell you that. We know you're getting a good deal on that, so actually we're not being compensated for buying out the overage. So we said to him, you need to buy at least 1 million of assets, which we will pick for you, right? So we went and got, we found 130 properties in like the ones I described, the 1 euro, 500 euro, 1,000, 10,000, whatever. So a lot of the rubbish that we had sitting around, and we sold them to him, right? So he bought us out of the overage, so he was happy. We got rid of 130 assets that actually nobody would buy, plus the one good one. So in a way, we used the upside that we made on the first deal to finance the second deal and help the bank get rid of as many assets as possible. These are the type of things that you need to be doing. That's why it's a bit more, you have so many assets and they have so many problems. And the push for speed is there. So you are forced to make a lot of decisions you can't sit around and just monitor the situation. It's like saying, I'm running the emergency ward in a hospital and saying, I'm monitoring the situation. What are you monitoring? People are falling apart. There's things that need to happen. You can't be sitting around in your office saying, I'm filling in a form.